right, so what about this? We get like a go-kart race, like in the cafeteria, like people on scooters running around, and we get like a guy in a banana costume.
No.
Okay, we make the whole video just about Mr. Klein.
No.
Senior video is doing like a week and we have nothing.
Well, what have the other seniors done?
Well, they've all captured the essence of their grade, so we could do that.
Like that?
Yeah.
Alright, so freshman year. What do we remember about freshman year?
I couldn't help but overhear. But do you remember that time when we entered each other's dreams, and everything was in slow motion? And there was that noise.
Yeah, that never happened.
Hmm, I suppose. But what about that time at Thompson Park?
Thompson Park, good.
I have to say, I will always remember Brandy Saunders' outfit from Thompson Park. It was like a pink jumpsuit. Like, what were you wearing? I'll always remember that from the first day like I saw you.
Thompson
did
Park.
This thing.
Wham bam.
What was it?
This? Sam bam.
A wham sam sam.
Yeah, and then you go, it's like a wham sam. Yeah, I don't remember
that
well.
I remember that.
And I did so much wham sam samming, I was exhausted.
What was it called? The bear fish?
Oh yeah.
Mosquito or something.
Yeah.
And we had to like, the class was split into two giant groups and we had to walk up. And that was the first, well it was the second day of school, but it was the first time I met Tyler Page. And
I was just gonna mention Tyler.
Yeah, and he was like, oh, feels like a dance battle. And I was like, this kid is cool.
I remember that there were certain people who I decided were quiet enough that I could try to make friends with them. And then I would go up to them and they'd walk away and
cool.
I'd get really discouraged.
The first thing I remember was we were playing some game where you had to like run across, we made a circle and you had to run across, and I remember Natasha made it to halfway through the circle and then she like fell on her face. But it was really funny though.
We had to do that chain thing where everyone like links arms and you have to unravel yourself, and me and Frank ended up on the outside of the thing. It was like me and Frank holding hands and then the rest of the group in a circle next to us. I don't even know how that happened.
It's a great way to
yeah.
make friends.
When you look back, you're like, look how young you are, and now look at us, we're all so much older and so much more mature. Not really.
On, it's on. I declare my rumor seem gone, then gone. It's too much that they say you need. It's not perfection yet. How boring if it is, nothing new for me.
Picnic Fridays.
No.
Shoes that are too small.
Definitely not a thing.
Got it. Think back to your most magical time at CHS with the most magical woman at CHS, Mrs. Sand.
Well, I don't think the beauty of all nature can be summed up in one movie.
That's true.
Okay,
Sand.
I remember sophomore year a lot better than freshman.
Sand is my homegirl. I love that woman so much.
Oh my god.
Don't you tell her you can't.
Mrs. Sant told me I blossomed like a flower.
Oh gosh, I need to tell my Sant story. There was this one time during fitness, we were outside, and there was this huge rainbow across the sky. So I was like, oh my gosh, I need to tell Mrs. Sant. So I go on the BBS and I send Miss Sant like, hey, I found a rainbow in the sky. It made me think of you. And she wrote like a paragraph explaining like how that made her day and made her life so much better. And every word was a different color, besides for the word rainbow, where every letter was a different color.
Oh my god, every time I see her, like whenever she comes and visits the school, I freak out and I like just do like a full sprint to her and give her a hug because, oh.
And I just remember the going into her class and she was like, all right, sit wherever you want because I like you to create your own aura. You need to create an aura. You need to create a really good atmosphere in this room. And I was like, all right, that's cool.
On the first day of English class, she told my third period class that the color of our folder was green because three and green rhymed.
So I start reading my thing and I'm like, all right, here's my leaf. Like, it's big, it's camouflage. She stops me. She's like, oh my god, say that again. So I said, it's camouflage. She's like, oh my god, that's the best word I've ever heard.
I remember Ray on like the first day. It was like we did our Shining Star project, and I didn't really know Ray, but I got to know him very well just by him saying, I drew another point on my star because my mom says I'm a special star.
You remember that time I gave everybody swine flu?
Oh yeah, it reminded me of that one sitcom, the one with the kid. Guys. I think I'm coming down with something.
I'm not surprised, Timmy. It's probably all that dust in your room. That place is a pigsty.
Mom, if Tim dies, can we turn him into bacon?
Okay.
Can I have your stuff?
When pigs fly.
Yeah, it lasted one season.
I worry about your home life.
I was out sophomore year. I actually was the one who got everyone sick. You're welcome, everyone.
Yeah, I brought the swine flu to CHS. Eric Gillies and I, actually, I was like patient zero, so I got a nice phone call that was like, do you have swine flu? You have swine flu. Like, don't come to school.
I had swine flu the last week of, what was it?
I had it right before that. Yeah, I had it, I think I gave it to you. I probably,
probably
not,
did.
Now that I'm thinking
probably
about it, I definitely infected you with the swine.
The swine.
The swine.
I actually got it. That was not fun.
I remember, I got all of drama clubsick with swine flu because that's when the drama play was happening.
So everyone in Miss Wilson's class got sick because of Eric Gillies. That's right, Eric Gillies.
Yeah, he was sick and then the person next to him got sick and then it went literally like down the row and then into the back row and there was always someone absent.
Eric Gillies was in the corner and it just like moved like a wave, just like the sickness down the hall, down the classroom.
I did like that she gave the whole wash your hands thing, because I always wash my hands for a very long time. People always make fun of me for it, but it finally became okay during that one period of time.
I forgot, but I remember me and Mike DeJoy were sanitizing everything. We would just put Purell in our hands and then rub everything in the classroom with Purell.
Getting vaccinated, like when you walked in and the front office, not front office, Moleshine's room, and they had it like set up like a doctor's office. It was a little eerie.
Mr. Gleason sent home a letter like restricting people from having parties after school or something right after I had like my 17th birthday party and everyone was violently ill at it and it was disgusting.
I survived.
Okay, so let's do something on senior year. Chris, what do you got? I gave you all last night to do this, Chris. What do you have?
I got robots in space.
Robots.
Mm-hmm. I can't really say that I have senioritis this year, because I probably have senioritis in sophomore year.
Oh, yeah.
Senioritis started on day one of freshman year for me.
It's just a grind. Like, the teachers assign homework, and you just, you're like, what? And then they...
You're like, but we're graduating in 7 months.
I hear your grades falling.
No,
I hear your grades falling. Senioritis started in September.
Like, right now is going on, if you couldn't tell.
Supposed to write a paper.
We're supposed to write a paper. I've been on the same paragraph for like 30 minutes.
The trip actually wound up being a lot of fun. I loved it.
We were really bad though.
Mm-hmm.
We were the first canoe out and the last canoe like in it. And Mr. Clark just like sat there with us.
We didn't even make it to the end of the canal. I don't even know how far that canal went.
We weren't very good. And then we realized that the only thing
is not our sport.
The only thing that everyone in the grade knows about us is that we make movies and like do DVD.
That's it. That's all we have. So every time we get to be like, oh, the DV boat's running into us again.
Oh
like,
no, it's the SS Film Kid. Run away.
Oh yeah. Oh yeah, falling in.
Falling in. Only one that did it.
I got back to the bus and looked at my phone like, oh, Lloyd must have been tweeting during this, and he had 3 tweets during the canoe trip.
And I just see them in the water and I just start laughing hysterically.
He probably tweeted like from like submerged like
no that's
in
what he
the
did. Like,
canal.
All of a sudden, I see something coming out of the water like this, and Steve with the face on him that was like this.
That was great.
Senior Thanksgiving.
That worked so well.
Bleeding. I liked the senior Thanksgiving. Everybody like bonded.
Oh, it was cute. It was so much fun.
There was so much more food there than I thought would actually be there.
I loved senior Thanksgiving. I really didn't think this was gonna happen, but actually I think like everyone in the grade more or less brought something in, and then we had whole 2 tables full of food and we were all there and like, it was cute.
And like some alumni were back and like Mel was there.
I think all the other grades were jealous of us because we were able to organize something as awesome as that.
I love JVB's class.
JVB's class, that was
a very funny
class. Best class. We had a good mix of people. And it just usually ended up with her yelling at us to like stop being inappropriate.
Stop picking on each other.
Everyone makes fun of me because I call her Miss JVV.
I call her Miss Vanderlady.
We did really good carousel writing stories. Like they were always ridiculous.
We're gonna make them out loud.
The first memory I have of JVV was freshman year, Halloween. I was walking down the hallway and then there's just like Viking lady in full garb with horned helmet just comes walking by and it's just like I'm just like you. I want to be you when I grow up.
In the end, we had a pretty good 4 years here at CHS.
That's true. We were the first class to win Spirit Week all 4 years.
We pulled together an amazing Thanksgiving feast.
Oh, we had Rice Acre.
This was our house.
And we were the only class to get banned from JVV's carousel riding.
That's not exactly something to brag about.
Good and bad memories aside, the class of 2011 has definitely left its legacy on CHS.
Guys, I've got it. Okay, what we're gonna do is
I like the people here more than people in my hometown.
Same.
Yeah, it's a friendly place. I mean, people are intelligent. You don't have to deal with morons.
We had some great experiences here. For all the stuff we complain about CHS, I loved it here.
Of course, there's times where it's hard, like when you have like 50 hours of homework a night and you're just like, why is this my life? But it's the best place anyone could be, I think,
mm-hmm.
in this kind of environment. It's great.
I love
it.
People will like talk about how it's like, you know, there's not this, there's not that, and it's so small, whatever. But I feel like it's made up for via other things that you wouldn't find elsewhere.
I feel like we've all grown closer, especially like senior year through all like the activities, like even our class as a whole, like the senior Thanksgiving and like the Christmas party, like I really feel like I got to know people that I never thought I would be friends with.
I'll miss all the different personalities, coming in here and having everyone that's kind of familiar and everyone that kind of tolerates me on a daily basis.
I would donate part of my liver to many of the people in this class.
You could like walk into like a class, just like say hi to a teacher and just like joke around a little bit, or just like at lunchtime all of our personalities coming out and everything. It was just a lot of fun here. I'm gonna miss it.
But I hope that we like all come back on senior whatever day. Alumni day, that day.
It's been fun. It's been fun, it's been real. Now off for life.
We cut the legs off of our pants, threw our shoes into the ocean, sit back and wave through the daylight. Sit back.